Well, guys, today I'm going to tell you about the mistakes you can find in this set. And here you can see what this set is all about. This is the MPP. Yes, the MPP 206 preamplifier. And over here we have the MAA 406 power amplifier. And as you can see, it is on protect now. And that's one of the two things this amplifier have mistakes. And these are serious mistakes, my friends. Serious mistakes you can resolve. That's why I make this video. When I bought this amp 9 months ago, I did not thought much about it. I thought, well, I was just curious how it sounded, and I never thought that I would love the thing so much that it would become ever my main amp. And for 2 months, it is now my main amplifier. 3 months is my main amplifier, because it took six months, my friends. Before, after the scoring time, it was all the time in my house, but I never connected the thing because I didn't thought much about the sound, to be honest. I heard many things that I'm not easy surprised by a sound. You know, I in the years I do this video, this hobbies, these videos on YouTube, I heard so many things that there isn't much over in sound that can surprise me, that I can say, yes, this is what I want as my main amplifier. Okay, the sound is not perfect. It is not an Accuphase, yes? I mean, Accuphase is better, sounds better than this. My Sansui G901DB, that monster amp, sounds better than this. And probably, well, I think my Sansui, my other Sansui, also sounds better than this. I have the 911DG, the AUX911DG. So it is not my best sounding amplifier, but it is one of the most beautiful sound amplifiers if the things goes on. That's the problem, because watch this, my friends. Watch this. It's out now, yeah? So stand by, and you can see, so the red light over here and the red light over here, it is stand by. The thing have a remote control. It's a little bit sad, remote control, but well, okay, it have a remote control. And when I push the thing on, yeah, okay, it goes on now. That is a normal thing if it goes on. Yeah, you would say, wow, what's wrong with that? That's normal. Okay, what's this? Yeah, okay. Well, this happens often. And with often, I mean, sometimes when you see, even when you try it for 30 minutes, yes, you try it every minute, it will stuck on protect. Watch it out, I wait a little bit, do it on again, yeah? Let's see what's happening now. Okay, it goes on. I switched it off now. I found a solution, because I only had that in the beginning. And because I have those blue LED lights, you see on the glass plate, I had on this switch that blue light. Oh, I see, okay. I had this on this switch, you know, this power cord goes to this other box, yes, and for the power cord I use this, and I think, okay, let's try something out. And then I placed the amplifier, the power amplifier, on that same switch, and I never had the problem anymore. So when I go to sleep, I switch off this thing, yeah? So the light is out. But also, as you can see, the standby is out, because this standby is still on, the red. You see the red light? And this standby, so it doesn't have power at all, because it is out, yeah? And it is on the same electricity box connected as those blue LED lights. And every morning when I wake up, I first do this. Yeah, the whole night it was out. I first do this. And then you see it is on standby again. My blue LED lights turn on, yeah? And then my friends, I switched it on. And normally you have to take a minute or so, a minute. But yeah, you see it goes on. So every morning it goes on without any problem, you know. But if I would not turn out this knob, yes, and I leave it like this, so I would leave my blue LED lights on in the night. Well, that is normal because LED light doesn't use that much power, so I could leave them on easy, but yeah, I switch them out every evening. And if I would leave them on, bet your life the next morning when I want to, when the thing stays in standby, when I want to power it off, I have the same problem. It doesn't want to go on. It will stay in protection. And to be honest, that was a very big mistake from Advanced Acoustics. A very big mistake, because this is a factory failure. Let me sit down over here on my table. This is a factory mistake. And I have contact with a guy who sold these items. He also sold these items. They are still selling in the shop. And as you can see, let's switch this thing on. Not a problemos. Yeah, go out. And okay. He told me that 40%, over 40% from these amplifiers came back in the shop as broken. They were in the guarantee, so people brought them back. They have problems, you know. And what I told you, what I just showed you now, what was one of the most, well, the most common problems they had, you know. You can call it sensitivity, yeah, but it is something else. It is a wrong design. They made a design mistake, and this can never happen with Acuphase. If Acuphase come out with a brand new amplifier, I mean a brand new design from the inside, they tested these amplifiers out, and maybe a few months, maybe 6 months before they go in production, and they make more as one item to test. They make maybe 10 or 20 of those items to test them over and over again. And when they see, okay, none of these 20 have a problem, then the production can start. This is how a normal factory, a factory what sells high-end, what have prices like Acuphase, should work. And probably they do. I never heard of a Acuphase with problems. Never, never. But this is Acuphase, okay? Oh, this is Advanced Acoustics. And you know what it is, my friends? It is very expensive to, if you have a product, and it's very expensive to build 20 or 50 prototypes, you know, and to test them for 6 months, and after 6 months you say, okay, the thing is reliable, we had only one fallout, no problem, you know, 49 are still good. We make 50 prototypes, we have five fallouts. Okay, you're gonna think, okay, that is 10%. Will we go on? That's doubtful. If you are Aquiphase, you will say no. That 10%, that five fallouts, 10% of the 50 is not good. We want zero fallouts. So Aquiphase will see what they can improve to keep that number on zero, zero defaults. But this is advanced acoustic. This is not Aquiphase. You know, they sell their products cheaper. So if they have a fallout from 2%, they are happy. They are happy, you know. But in this case, 40%, this is ridiculous, you know. But lucky, you know, it is the survival of the brand. They saw in their mistake because they got all those amplifiers back in the shop. And they brought out not soon after this amplifier came out, because this amplifier came out in 2006, I think in 2007 or 2008, they came out with the advanced acoustic, the same advanced acoustic MAA406, but with a switch on the back, and you can switch that amplifier to or A class or A and B class. Yes, this amplifier is from the first production, so the 406 without that switch on the back. So if you're ever gonna buy, if you want to buy a 406, my friends, try to buy a 406 with that switch on the back. I think they repaired that mistake. They found out the problem in the design, and they repaired that mistake, because why else would you bring out after 1 or 2 years a 406 with a switch? The only change was a switch on the back. And why would you bring out after 1 or 2 years another design or another amplifier? The name stayed the same. It was still a 406, but only that switch on the back changed. And probably those 406, those advanced acoustic 406s, do not have that problem, you know. And I will make a video where I will open the hood from this amp. I will open the hood from this amp, because I think they are exactly the same amplifiers. Only this one is, of course, the improved version of the amp, of this amp. All the mistakes they found in this amp, you know, the amps what went back to the shops because they were broken. Of course, much of them were already repaired, those mistakes, the design changes in that second 406. And of course, this is a 2013 model. They are still selling in the shop. Most of the mistakes or the failures they kept out, or they changed. They recognize the problems, and these latest amplifiers do not have these mistakes, these failures anymore. But still, the guy told me that still amplifiers came back to the shops with some mistakes, some even with the same mistake, with the sensitivity that we know what I just showed you here, with the same mistake, but it was less as 10%, and that's normal. You know, less as 10% is normal for a brand with, for a brand as advanced acoustic, or for a price class in the amplifiers in this price class. Yeah, it was the number what came back in the shop, he told me, was normal on the 10%. Yes, but from this type, you know, the first one, 40% came back. And as you can see, I just explained you the it's nothing to do with the quality. I have another guy, a friend, he is on Boudewijn Veerhuis. He told me years ago, never buy Harman Kardon, new Harman Kardon, because within 2 years, within the guarantee period, many of those Harman Kardons came back in the shops. I mean, I'm talking about those 5.1, 7.1, you know, those modern AV receivers, came back to the working place for repair. And he told me that they use very cheap components, yes, and that's why they broke so fast. This amplifier, this mistake is not because of cheap components, no. The mistake is because of a wrong design, a design failure, you know, a problem that they thought, okay, we have a prototype, it is working, and, you know, these guys are, you know, I mean, it's a little bit Mickey Mouse, you know, you understand what I mean? I had contact with that importer from this brand, from the Netherlands, because I was interested to review that new advanced acoustic A10. And that was end of September, I think half September. No, let me see, November, October. Half of October I had contact with this guy on telephone. Half October, yeah. And then on the website they showed that advanced acoustic A10 with these same VU meters, and but that was a new model. It was a hybrid integrated amplifier. So it had a hybrid preamp, and you could see that those two tubes in the middle, an orange lighted, and two VU meters, one on the right side and one on the left side, that modern A10, advanced acoustic A10. And then he told me, well, the meters will be different. I think the meters will be different. And it will comes out in November. In November it will be in the shop, so in a month from now, you know, within a month it will be in the shops. I have the new type in my house, and I think, well, you only need 1 month to you know, to control the thing. Normally you have to check a thing for at least a few months, every day on and on, see what are the weak points of this amp, so you can change it before it goes in production. But probably these guys used a already existing amplifier board, a pre-amplifier board at Cedar. The DACs were already existing and implemented before in other products they sold. So they implanted it all together in that new integrated with only different VU meters, and they were very fast, very fast. It is a very fast working company, you know. It's, I mean, you already know what the thing is going to look, but you know you will have some other VU meters. Okay, strange. I can tell you that Accuphase, if you have an amp like this, 2x160 watt, a power amp from Accuphase, you will pay 8,000 minimum, my friends, 8,000 euro minimum. So that's the difference with a company with high standards, you know, and a company like Advanced Acoustic. But, because they used this, I think they used the same amplifier like they use in this amp. Only they improved it. They take out the failures, and that's why this one is so good. In principle, it's an old amplifier with some upgrades, of course, and they changed the exterior, you know, and that's all. And so, in a way, that's why it was designed in France, you know. But I mean. If you make such a big failures, these are big failures, and I believe that they designed it in France. But if you made such big failures, I think this company tried to be, they are very good in the designing, in the outside designing. The most expensive thing from an amplifier like this is the travel and the housing. That's the most expensive. Yes, the print boards with all the pot meat, the pots, and everything else is cheap stuff. This is the most expensive thing: the housing and the travel. And they do a very good job in designing the outside. The inside, they made in the beginning failures, but from this, what I understand, this one is failure proof, or it can be that you still, if you buy a new one, you still have a failure, you have to go back, a factory failure, that is. You have to go back to that shop because it have a failure. But it is under 10%. Well, this was 40% and more. And another failure is, as you can see over here, you see that this light have three bulbs working. Yes, the new type, because the VU meters are bigger, have four bulbs working for every VU meter. And you can see that this VU meter, the bulbs do not have a problem at all. Yeah, but this one have a problem. This one over here, as you can see, the right bulb is out. When you first power the thing up, the right one is flickering and the left one is flickering. And after a while, the right one goes out, and then the left one also goes out after 30 minutes, and only the middle bulb stay working. This, I first thought it was a problem. It was a problem from the LED bulb, but that's not the case. What I understand now, you have to renew a resistor somewhere on the board, a resistor, and then this problem is gone. Just a resistor, just a matter of they used the wrong resistors. So matter of change the resistor and the problem is gone. That's all. You know, if this hinders you, you know, if you have the same amplifier with the same problem, because this problem is not 1 on 100 or 1 on 1,000. No, this problem is maybe 20 or 30 for every 100. So often you can see this problem in these amplifiers. What you can do, if it bothers you, bring it to a local specialist, you know, a local repair guy, and tell him it is a resistor, and so he can find it for you, and he will repair it for you. Just a matter of, yeah, you have it will cost you, of course, it will cost you, but then he can. Or you bring it to Advanced Acoustic yourself, also to the importer. The importer knows exactly this problem because they had many of these amplifiers back in their workplace. So they know exactly what to do, you know. And these are the two mistakes you can find in these amplifiers. Are they bad? No, the sound is, I love the sound. If I would not like the sound, I would never have had it as my main amplifier for these last 2 months. I have it now for 2 months as my main amplifier, yeah. But also, you know, I have better sounding amplifiers, but this is not a bad sounding amplifier. The sound is very nice, my friends. But it's not my best amplifier. I had better amplifiers, and but I love the looks, and that's why it stayed. And now this one, I will sell this one. I already sold it. I only have to make this video and 2 other more videos from this setup, and then this beautiful monster, the same 2x 160 watt, will replace it. And well, this was the video. I hope if you ever are planning to buy a set like this, you now know what to look for if it have these mistakes. And if you're gonna buy this amplifier, watch in the back if it have that switch, if it have that A class or A B class switch on the back. If it have that switch, then probably you have a device without these failures. If you see that you're gonna buy a MAA 406 without that switch, I would not take the risk, my friend, because the chance is that you will have these two problems, what I just showed you. The chance is big that you will buy an amplifier with 50% chance that you will buy an amplifier with these two problems, yes? Or maybe one of these two problems, yes? And so that's why I make this video. You know, if you are a follower of me, you are now warned. If you like this design, I can understand. It is a beautiful thing, my friends. A beautiful. It is these. I love designers who are designers. You know, and that's what I miss in normal stuff. The Wilsonton R8, the tube amp was beautiful designed, beautiful. But I see so much stuff from China, and I think if only they had better designers, you understand, the thing was, you know, much, it would be a much higher value for me personally. And like this Bryston, you know, this Bryston over here, this Bryston 4BST, I mean, I do not think Bryston have a problem with, they know they sell quality, everybody they know, so they sell quality, the studios don't mind. But if they would sell the same products with a design like this, my friends, they would sell double they sell now. I mean, for the same, what would it cost, you know? I mean, a VU meter like this costs you maximum 30 euro. 30 euro. You have two of them, 60 euro, you know? A little bit changing in the front, it will cost you maybe 150 euro more. You know, production cost, maybe 100 euro more production cost, only 100 euro production cost. So in the shop it would be 200 euro more expensive. Well, I mean, persons who have this Bryston, who pay so much for Bryston, I think they will not mind the 200 euro extra for a more beautiful example, a more beautiful amplifier. You can call the one, you can leave the old Bryston like this and call it Pro. So for the studio use and for the band and for the professional use, Pro. And you can make the same amplifiers but with a different look, a beautiful look. And those one you will call, you will not say Pro but Home, you know, Home. Suitable for your home, a beautiful device. A little bit more expensive, but I think they will sell many for home use, more than they sell now. And that's why I like Advanced Acoustic. They know how to design, my friends, but they, in a way, I think they learn. They learn from their mistakes, and probably, I hope in the future, they will make quality stuff without these problems, you know. That's why I tell you, if something is new in the shop, wait 6 months, a year, and then see on the forums what people say about this product. Do they have problems? What do they think about the sound? You know, and after a year you can say, okay, I wasn't the first one with this product, but I bought it at a time others had experience with this thing, so I now know this thing is a perfect product, or I didn't bought it because many people had problems with the device when they bought it in the shop new. Yeah, well, thanks for watching this video. I hope you like it. Put those thumbs up if you did, and for now I say ciao ciao.